North American waterfowl flourish in a diversity of species. Their health is often determined by their populations, which in part are related to the natural ebb and flow of weather conditions. Growing in numbers during years of heavy precipitation and declining in the drier ones. But for the past several years, one species in particular, the northern pintail duck, has broken ranks with tradition by not rebounding as other species have during seemingly favorable conditions. Wildlife biologists, land managers, and conservationists alike are concerned about the pintail and what might be happening to its habitat. They want to understand why this particular species is losing its battle for recovery.
At one point in time, pintails were rivaled mallards in the prairie pothole region with respect to number of breeding birds. Back in the 50s, you were looking at somewhere, you know, between 8 and 10 million breeding pairs. When the drought of the 60s hit, those numbers declined just like all duck species did. When habitat conditions increased in the 70s, all ducks rebounded, including the pintails. The 80s came along, another drought hit the prairie pothole region, all ducks suffered. That's just nature, that those things happen. But when the 90s, in the mid-90s, when water returned to the prairie pothole region, a lot of ducks responded marvelously. You see mallards, gadwall, had record numbers, but pintails just didn't respond.
Although its population has declined, the northern pintail is still considered the most widely distributed of all ducks. Its migratory path has been documented from the northwestern banks of Alaska to the Yucatan Peninsula of Mexico. Given their name for the long black center tail feathers, the pintail is a medium-sized dabbling duck that feeds off grains like rice, seeds from marsh vegetation, and aquatic invertebrates. It's a hardy duck with a tendency to live a long life, more so than other species. All the more concern for wildlife biologists.
Habitat needs to be focused on because habitat is the reason why pintail numbers have declined. You've seen landscape changes in the prairie pothole region from the northern parts of the U.S., North Dakota, South Dakota, all the way up into southern Canada. Changes in agricultural practices, all these things are pieces of the puzzle that have resulted in declines in pintail numbers.
Ty Anderson, a graduate student in wildlife management at Texas A&M University in Kingsville, is studying the pintail's different habitats by using radio telemetry. Ty and fellow students, along with Texas Parks and Wildlife biologist David Lowprice, must first attract the pintails to a free dinner of rice.
There are several landowners that are adjacent to this property that farm rice, and rice seems to be a favored food of the pintail.
The goal will be to capture several pintail hens and outfit them with small radio transmitters in order to track them on their return journey to the north.
Typically, pintails will arrive on the Texas coast sometime in early October. We start to see large groups come in a little bit later than that.
Middle toe, 4675.
Ty and the team will spend the next several hours banding, recording physical measurements, and equipping each pintail with its own radio transmitter. A nylon harness is carefully fitted on the duck, which is secured to the transmitter with weather-resistant glue. Paper is inserted under the unit to prevent any excess glue from coming in contact with any part of the duck's body. Once the transmitters are secured and activated, the pintails are ready to return to the wild.
Each bird has an individual frequency that we can dial into on the receiver. We radio tagged 157 female pintails, and we're trying to get habitat use and movements along the Texas mid-coast.
The pintail hens are tracked until they return to migration, but not all of the birds will be sending back preferred radio signal.
Each radio transmitter is set to give 60 pulses a minute. Once bird is on mortality, or have an idea that that bird might be dead, that rate will double. It's fairly noticeable. We're tracking and you hear one that's on mortality, she sticks out from the rest of the crowd. So as soon as we hear a mortality, we try to go out and recover that bird. This is kind of typical of what we've seen so far with mortalities. When we go out to recover one of these birds that appear to have died, typically we're not finding any remains or carcass. So kind of leaves it up in the air as to what type of predator got to this hen.
Here in the rainwater basin of Nebraska, part of the prairie pothole region, wildlife biologists traverse geographic borders in hopes of further documenting potential habitat challenges for the pintail.
I am actually from Canada, Saskatchewan, and I have a great deal of waterfowl experience, mostly telemetry. What we are collecting is daily locations on every bird that we find in the rainwater basin area. Here it's mostly movement. It's where they're feeding in the short term, whether it's days or weeks that they spend as they pass through. So it's critical that we collect as much data on as many birds as we can to see what they're doing, what is important here, what habitat, what wetlands, so that we can sustain them and so they have a good staging area before they head up north to breed.
What we're doing here is we're tracking birds that have been marked in Texas. The birds were marked in Texas last fall, and that gives us a lot of advantages here. Now we can get good estimated residency times and survival rates here without having the effect of handling the bird immediately before and after the time of capture. There's a lot of speculation on winter survival problems for pintails. They're an early nester. They have some problems in the breeding areas. Personally, I'm a duck hunter, and I like to be around a lot of waterfowl, and I sure would hate to see pintails go down the tubes in the next few years because we're not doing something that everything we can do to manage for them as well as we can.
It's been said that the pintail may be the canary of the prairies. Just like the miners use canaries to keep themselves out of trouble, the pintail may be an indicator species of what's going along in the prairie pothole region of the U.S. and Canada. We think that there's problems because other species have rebounded, but they don't nest in necessarily the same place that pintails do. And so pintails may be an indicator of a bigger problem down the road. And through our research, through our management, we need to try to do everything we can to ensure that the pintails do recover, which is a sign of a healthy ecosystem.